day today for me. From arrived straight to the PBS AGM, and then we went to launch Ben Bonio Highway. There's a stretch of what do you call Kudatan in Aman, and then we saw the construction of the Kapar Dogongan stretch, and then I went to see this IBS school under construction. That's at Kapar. Apa nama? Tanaki. Eh? Tanaki. Sekolah Kebangsaan Tanaki. Was burned down.
Kita rasa surprise. Sangat seronok. Tak tahu apa nak cakap pada ketika itu. Rasa amat terperanjat lah.
We are very surprised. Sampai saya mau makan pun susah.
Dia tadi soalan lebih banyak. Saya betul-betul duduk one seat beside him after CM. So, yalah, all the perasaan tu berkecamuk dalam satu lah.
Secara generalnya bincang tentang post budget. So apa pandangan sebagai seorang rakyat Malaysia dengan budget sebagai individually sebagai orang Sabah sendiri.
Kita juga berbincang berkaitan dengan bagaimana budget ini boleh memberikan manfaat kepada masyarakat di Sabah secara khususlah.
We may have to introduce legislation kalau dia tak buat voluntarily sama the company. But I think there must be a good work-life balance. I think 90 days is a good stretch. Because you need that time to bring up your infant.
We asked about our 90 days maternity leave. And then it, definitely it's a game changer compared to previous budget, right?
I'm married, okay, with two kids. So my wife always cerita pasal, you know, maternity leave, macam mana tidak cukup untuk ibu-ibu walau untuk 2 bulan, should be increased to 3 months. And it is, you know, PM cakap tadi, we try to make it compulsory for everyone, okay, every company to ada 90 hari.
In fact, even the husband gets time off and also early time off from work to be with the wife.
Wife in KK, husband in Kuala Lumpur tak boleh lah.
Kadang-kadang kita tengok daripada benda yang jauh tau, you know, like okay berapa billion, this billion. Tapi benda-benda yang kecil ni lah, so-called kecil ni lah yang will touch the people's heart. So those are the things that I love, the tiny bits here and there. Tapi actually betul-betul sampai ke rakyat.
He told us about how he liked the seafood in Sabah, and then his favorite. He is a avid Man United fan.
How many of you are MU fans here?
I'm not MU. I'm Chelsea.
Oh, you're Chelsea. Very.
He's very approachable, you know, from the questions that we ask. The santainess that I try to bring, okay, tanya soalan pasal MU, I'm an MU fan, tanya pasal bola, tanya pasal rumah, other than of course bercerita pasal budget dan sebagainya. So he's a very nice guy lah, I would say, you know, boleh cakap biasa, tanya, you know, the protocol is not really there, makan, siap ambilkan, kautkan, so yeah.
It's easy to talk to him, it's very friendly, and he all of us get to talk to him, and then we get to exchange our opinion. He's very open about different kind of different opinion.
Yeah, if you can give them a few hits,
yeah,
of dairy cattle, they say 30 ekor, let them manage, and then they can the milk.
Dia seorang yang peramah, malah memberikan mendengar semua idea-idea yang kami sampaikan berkaitan dengan isu pembangunan, isu budget. Dan banyak isu-isu yang berkaitan dengan negeri Sabah. Beliau mendengar dan beliau memberikan maklum balas yang sangat signifikan, yang sangat bagus.
Digital economy, as stated in the
Yeah.
It's very good for us.
Digital Malaysia or digital economy will be the sector that you can get double digit growth. That's what I want. I want a company. I want to live for.
Yeah, Dr. Sri, I'm very happy for the Ken Borneo punya highway. Sebab being in sales, saya kena pergi semua pos Malaysia di Sabah. So saya kena pergi di different area. So I've been through that roads yang very rosak. So I think kan macam Ken Borneo ni bagus. But the thing is, I hope that maintenance boleh terus teruskan lah. Sebab jalan kita banyak kali betulkan. Lori balak lalu, lori tak pasalkan. So dia rosak. Sampai di masa tu tayar kita begini, tu jalan bang begitu alu. So alu.
Kita membawa isu-isu berkaitan dengan kemajuan masyarakat luar bandar, keseimbangan ekonomi di antara Semenanjung dan juga Sabah dan Sarawak, isu-isu tentang pembangunan yang berkaitan dengan pembangunan ekonomi, pembangunan masyarakat luar bandar.
Ken Borneo highway, the quality is much higher. And it's highway quality. So with highway quality, dia boleh tahan lama lah. But obviously we have to think of the maintenance.
Of course, PM share about, you know, as I mentioned before lah, Ken Borneo punya ni, and then beberapa allocation untuk orang-orang luar bandar.
He has a good memory. He knows what he has said in speeches. And then when somebody throw him some question, he can answer it. So yeah, I'm quite amazed.
Pagi besok saya kena pergi Pekan lah, first thing.
How do you maintain?
I used to do about 3 times a week, tapi now I'm trying to vary sikit. Kalau tak dapat, you know, long session, dapat 15-20 minutes pun cukup. But you do it frequently.
Every day.
You do it like, if you can do it every day, even better. Kalau tidak, at least the idea is 150 minutes a week. That is ideal exercise level, 150 minutes a week.
Malam-malam pun ada meeting, you know. Especially when we prepare the budget. Oh my god, ASEAN dengan APEC. ASEAN was the worst. The first day ASEAN was on a Tuesday di Manila. It started from 9 o'clock in the morning. We finish at 12:30 at night. So then the next morning, because the last session was with Guterres, the UN Secretary General. We started at about 11 something, finished by 12. So I ada masa balik rumah sikit, you know, makan, semayang, apa semua. Then I went to the last session. The next day, we started at 9, we finish at 9:30 at night.
Stop. So,
this,
very stressful.
Very stressful.
How do you control stress?
Well, it's not good to exercise. Give it a positive attitude.
Chicken one.
Cats. Yeah, I need a chuchu rice. Right? Yeah. I need chuchu.
Tengok bola sikit.
Tengok bola. Tapi kalau kalah, stress.
Jumpa dengan Yang Amat Berhormat PM. Comes from different background. Ada professor, ada yang orang cakap tu bisnes sendiri, ada yang daripada macam-macam lah. Even myself is from the entertainment industry. Jadi masing-masing ada input masing-masing dalam dia orang punya apa ni bidang kan?
Definitely this is a dream come true, and it's also something I never expected. Yeah.
Saya berasa lebih senang dan lebih kenal siapa Perdana Menteri kita.